and welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited to have you here. So today, you guys already know the dealio. It is Friday and I always read people's MLM horror stories slash experiences. And if you have a horror story of your own and you want to submit it to me, I have my email down below for you to submit it to. So we're going to get right into it. Grab your water. This is the best. This is the most... I can't even say how good this water bottle is. I'm not sponsored, even though I wish Simply Modern would sponsor me. But this keeps my water so freaking cold. So freaking cold. Literally, my ice will still be in it tomorrow. Like, that is how amazing this water bottle is. So, I'll link that down below for you guys. Let's get into it. So this one starts with saying, I lost my best friend to Unique. I have sent this to another anti-MLM YouTuber, but she never shared my story. I want to hear it because I want them to know how MLMs can destroy friendships. Well, then this is the channel for you because I'm going to get through all of my MLM horror stories before I ever stop this series, which I hope it doesn't stop, so share your stories with me. This is my story of how I lost my best friend to Unique. I met my best friend when I was 8 years old on the school playground. We became instant best friends the way kids always do. But our friendship did not stop there. We stayed best friends through elementary school, though middle school and up till our late 20s. My dad used to call us the two musketeers all our lives because we did everything together. When my family went on vacation every summer, she would come with us. We were the female versions of Sean Hunter and Corey Matthews of Boy Meets World. I hope you get that reference. I'm in my 30s, so I'm aging myself. No, I get the reference. I got you. When her parents went through an ugly divorce when we were both 16, she came to live with me and my family for 4 months because it was an ugly divorce. We were like sisters. When the college I applied to denied my entrance, she cried with me and held me together. We were always there for one another through thick and thin. I was the maid of honor at her wedding. She was the maid of honor at mine. Even after we moved to two different states as adults, we would meet up 2 times a year and stay at a hotel and catch up for the weekend. We would Skype every week. My kids called her auntie. Anyway, over 3 years ago, she joined Unique, and that was the beginning of the end for our close friendship. She didn't change all at once. It happened so gradually. She started out missing our Skype calls because she was working her business. I was totally understanding, especially in the beginning, because she would do Facebook Live videos every night after our kids were in bed. I would love seeing her every night, actually, and I always shared her live videos and loved chatting with her and the other women who hopped on the live video feed. It was fun. She asked me to join her downline and was super understanding of my busy schedule and said she just appreciated me supporting her through sharing her videos. I bought just about every product Unique had to offer because I genuinely wanted to see her succeed. Some products I liked, others I didn't. But I was so happy that she was getting some commission from it, so I didn't mind. Slowly, she started changing. Her whole life became about Unique, and there didn't seem to be room for anything else. That's all she talked about when we did speak, which was not a lot because she barely picked up my phone calls. As she rose in the company, our friendship seemed to be less and less important to her. She canceled our next 3 catch-up trips where we would meet at the hotel for a weekend. I missed her so much. But if I mentioned missing her, she would bring up that we spend time together during her live videos. Yes, I love seeing her live, but I also wanted to see her and not hear about makeup or her team in the company. By the way, she grew her team pretty quick, and she is currently a black status leader for the company. Well, over 1 year ago, I had a health scare. I was in the hospital getting tests after tests, and I was really worried. The doctors had no clue what was wrong with me and said it could be anything from cancer to lupus. I called and left her a message about it. She never called me back. She did send a quick text saying she was praying for me, but that was it. I kept seeing her on live videos while I was in the hospital, and I was incredibly hurt. She had time for live videos. She had time for her team. She had time for posting generic photos on her Instagram, but didn't have time to call me while I was in the hospital with health complications. My husband even called her and told her he would pay for her flight to come and see me, but she gave some excuse as to why she couldn't. The straw that broke the camel's back was the day when she was doing a quote-unquote my why video. She was talking about why she joined the company and all the ways it changed her life. She acted as if her life before Unique was pointless. Then she said that she never had a real friend before she joined the Unique Sisterhood. I watched the video, shocked that she would say such a thing. My husband can tell you that he held me while I cried all night long. Literally, I was so beyond hurt that she would say our friendship wasn't real when we had the type of friendship that was so deep. After a few days of processing the hurt, I did call her to hash it out. Although she apologized for the way it came out, she didn't actually apologize for saying it. She kind of said, well, you know what I mean. And I was thinking, no, I don't know what you mean. Because what you basically said was that all of those years of friendship that was so real for me meant hardly anything to you. Anyways, I still catch her on live videos, but that is the only time I see her. I still text her our inside jokes and call her on her birthday and Christmas, but she has become more of an acquaintance than anything. I will always love her. She was always such a huge part of my life, but isn't really in it anymore and it breaks my heart. Sorry for the length of this message. I just wanted to let you know that your videos explaining how these companies manipulate women give me hope that it isn't truly coming from her, but coming from that cult mentality. Maybe one day we'll get back to where we were. Why is that the saddest shit I have ever read? And that's the reality of these MLMs, right? It's like unexplainable. Like I literally have goosebumps right now and I'm a little emotional. I'm looking at the mirror like, okay, girl, it's okay. But that's hurtful. And I can actually relate to the MLM person a little bit because when you said she did her My Why video, that was always a video that I was told to do when I was in Beachbody. You always had to have your why video whenever you would do like an information session, or you would always have to share your why. And they always made you really truly believe that the company was your why. Like the company was the reason why you are better mentally, better physically, better emotionally, financially, and they really make you believe that. So yeah, your friend may think that, you know, nothing or her life before the MLM was pointless or she didn't have anything good going for her, but it could also equally be that that's just how MLMs make you think. And I'm not saying everyone thinks this way or that this person did think this way, but I'm saying I even had those times in my MLM where I was like, wait, did the MLM help me through my anxiety? Or did me getting up every day, making a morning routine, starting to work out, starting to actually eat right and do the things that make someone, you know, become healthier physically and mentally and getting out of the house and all those things, did that help me? And I started to realize after a while that the MLM isn't what, oh, my anxiety's gone, my depression is gone just because of the MLM. No, that was me. I made the steps to become better mentally, physically, and all of those ways. So again, it could so be that your friend is just in that mentality, and I'm so sorry. I wish there was like something I could do to help you or help all of the people going through this where they lose a friendship or they lose a spouse because of this or a girlfriend or a boyfriend. And it just sucks. It really sucks. So I really am so sorry for that. Let me know what you guys think down below. Give her some encouragement because I know that's not easy to express a situation that's so sad like that. So wow, that was really touching. So I'm gonna move on to the next horror story, even though I could just end it here. That'd be it for today's horror story because that one is just so sad within itself. So the next one is a little bit shorter. It goes, hey Deanna, my name is Amanda and you are more than welcome to use my name. Having recently discovered the anti-MLM movement and watching your videos and other anti-MLM YouTubers, it has caused me to reflect on my experience with MLMs. But just to be clear, I've never been in one myself. My cousin, however, oh God, has been in 3 or 4, including Mary Kay, Party Light, an MLM that sells candles, Close to My Heart, and Stampin' Up, 2 scrapbooking MLMs. This caused my mom and me to buy products from her to support her business. However, like many people in MLMs, she bought more than she sold, and I believe she made no money. I'm also not sure if she recruited anybody else, but the chances are good that she did. Eventually, she left all MLMs, and as far as I know, she has not been recruited to anything else. My other experience is that I have bought plenty of MLM products to include Avon, Mary Kay, Scentsy, 31, and Young Living, to name a few. My story regarding Young Living was a distributor was brought into my university to not only sell expensive oils, but to recruit young, broke college students. Disgusting. My last experience was about a month ago. See enclosed screenshot. I had joined a Facebook group for grad students as I had just graduated with a bachelor's in criminology, and I'm heading into a master's in library and information science, and wanted to connect with other grad students. My first day in the group was an Amway hun posted on the Facebook page advertising Slay the Day focused gummies. I thought, not too cool, bro. You're pitching a shitty product to broke grad students, and no one wants gummies that probably taste like yak shit anyways. Anyways, girl, thank you for sharing my stories and helping save people from these MLM companies. So this is the post that the MLM rep had shared into the group. So clearly this is a group with a bunch of grad students and college students, which grad students, a lot of them are, you know, in debt. Like, you've gone through so much school. You've already, what, gone through an associate's, a bachelor's. Like, you're all the way up there, okay? You have probably done 4-ish years of schooling already. So yeah, a lot of those people don't have all the money in the world. She goes, "Hi everyone. I know everyone is gearing up for the upcoming fall semester, including myself. I want to recommend an Energy Plus focus supplement. That way you don't gain weight from drinking those unhealthy energy drink and snacking habits." No, she didn't. "I've been using Slay the Day Focus gummies, natural B vitamins, ginseng, I don't know how to pronounce that word, and none of the sugar. It works so well for me. I really want to share it with you guys. It's so perfect for students. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to post product recommendations on here, but here's the link if you like to order some. Feel free to reach out if you have any questions. Have an awesome semester, everybody." So not only is she pitching to broke grad students, which not all grad students are broke though, but you guys catch the drift. She's also trying to say that all college students gain weight because they're drinking unhealthy energy drink and they have bad snacking habits. Rude. That is so rude. Like, that is beyond rude. I would definitely have messaged that group, like the admin of that group, and have said something about this post, because I would have gotten it removed, because a lot of grad students are looking for things to keep them awake and keep them going. So hopefully no one bought into that, but that is pretty crappy. Okay, my camera just died, but I am back. I put in a new battery for all of my people who do YouTube or aspiring YouTubers. Y'all always gotta have a backup battery, because the most annoying thing ever is when you're in the middle of filming and your battery goes dead, just dies, and then you have to charge it and wait. Yeah, no, not happening. Okay, so into the next one. This one says, "Hey Deanna, hopefully this is a good one. I included screenshots of some stuff. Just keep her name anonymous. Thanks, and I hope you enjoy." There's a lot of screenshots too, which you guys know I love. This says, "Hey girl, so I just recently got into watching anti-MLM videos, and let me say, I love them. I watch them constantly, and it has made me realize how much of the stuff my friends and family have used that are products of MLMs. I have also realized that businesses my mom and aunt have been a part of were MLMs, but I was just a kid when that happened, so obviously I had no idea. So when I started watching anti-MLM content, I realized I had only been asked maybe twice in my life to join one of these schemes. I figure this is because I have a pretty private Instagram and don't really use Facebook. So I thought I was safe from the scams until I tried selling something on an app earlier to Kijiji. Is that a person's name? This woman wanted to pick something up from me, which is great. So we set up a time and place. It was horrible. She flaked the first night after she said she was on her way 2 times and then lied about being on her way the next day. She was super nice, but very confused and seemed like she had a lot on her plate. Then she finally said she left the house. I opened my phone to say okay, and here is a terribly long paragraph that she sent me. First, it was just her telling me to look at her items for sale, which was fine. Then she started talking about leggings, and I was immediately like, shit. This lady was a part of not one, not two, but 3 MLMs. Young Living, Leggings Galore, and It Works. She went on as for to ask if I wanted to host a party at her own house. When she got to my house, my dad was outside and he told her that she was going to be sending me some information, and I just know she's going to be sending me more information about her pyramid schemes. I also made the mistake of innocently giving this lady my phone number before I realized that she was going to do more than just text me when she was on her way. It just bugs me that I was simply trying to sell her an item on a buy and sell site, and then I ended up with my very own MLM story. They really are on every platform, and it's annoying. And I now have to think about it while trying to get rid of stuff." Okay, that is annoying. The fact that you are on a site to sell something, for example, like if you're on Facebook Marketplace or Poshmark, you should not be getting MLM reps that are commenting on your product you're trying to sell, where they're like, "Oh yeah, I wanna buy it. Yeah, can I just have your number? Like, let's just exchange numbers. I'm on my way. You flake 3 times, but in all actuality, it's like you don't even wanna buy her product she's selling. You wanna sell her your product? It just doesn't make, the logic doesn't make sense to me. So Let's see some of these screenshots. The first screenshot is from the MLM rep. It goes, I don't know if you're interested. I also have plants for sale and I have legging capri shirt dresses with pockets in my bedroom store is what I call it. If you have kids, I have Bubble Guns brand new car fire truck, pink dolphin, blue dolphin. They make noise and they light up. Not to mention, I have painting activities. Example, I have a house that's a piggy bank, blah, 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 blah. Leggings galore by blank. It then says, if you would like to come shopping, the leggings are all set up in the text messaging is a timer to come over. House host a party, you will receive a free pair of leggings. Right away, away. In addition, for every $250 spent, your freebies increase. Is this a copy and paste message? Because she makes no damn sense. So I'm not even going to read all of this, but essentially she is sending one long message that goes for how many screenshots? 1, 2, 3, 4. And she starts off with talking about those kids things. She then talks about her leggings. She also puts the link to the leggings. She then talks about another thing. Then she talks about Young Living with her young, she even gives her Young Living ID number and the Young Living website. And then she gives her It Works coffee website, her It Works ID number, her It Works email, and then it keeps going. It just keeps on dang going. What in the? And then the only response, this is after 4 screenshots worth, she just wrote her a whole book. Our girl responds and says, sorry, did you stop by and pick up the $5 headband? And our girl goes, all of that while, I was just trying to sell a headband. And in the background of a picture she sent me, I could see lists of people's phone numbers jotted down. And I feel bad because it's definitely to send messages about her MLMs. Oh, I have no words. I have no words. I have nothing to say. I can't show all the screenshots because I would have to blur out like so much stuff because she has literally her ID number for all of these MLMs, her emails to all of the MLMs, an explanation of all of the MLMs. For the It Works one, she even talks about how she weighed 181 pounds and now she weighs 120 and it only costs $100. Like, oh my, no, just no. It gets worse. It gets worse. You know, I thought we would stop at Bumble BFF. I thought that would be it. I thought that would be the end of it. But no, no, they're on selling websites and then they do this. They get your number and then they send you a book. Okay, a book to read with all of their MLM ID numbers and emails. Just know. I have no words. What do you guys think down below about that? Because just know. Let's move on to the next MLM horror story. And this one's going to be about Mary Kay. It goes, hey Deanna, my husband and I love your channel. He suggested that I share my MLM experience with you. Here it goes. About 5 years ago, my husband and I had just gotten married and he had just bought our first house. And I let my best friend host the Mary Kay party at our house. The rep came and we had the party. I didn't buy anything because I don't wear Mary Kay. The rep started talking to us about a big opportunity she had for us to make extra money if all we would do is sign up to sell Mary Kay. My other 2 friends who came to the party said no, but stupid me, I was intrigued. She went on to tell me it would only be $100 to start up and to get my starter kit. She showed me the awesome Mary Kay bags I would get for signing up. I told her I would have to talk to my husband first. He was at home at the time of the party watching baseball. I asked if he would come down and talk to the rep with me. She talked me into wanting to join and my husband paid the $100. Because he wanted to make me happy, even though he didn't think it was a good idea, even though he didn't tell me until later. After we paid the $100, I was given a cubic zirconia ring to wear, and that day I planned my first party to be held at my husband's aunt's house in the city. The rep gave me a folder with a DVD that I had to watch, which had tips on how to sell to people, how to act while at your party, and how to recruit people. The rep said she would be at my party to provide help if I needed. The day of the party came. Found out I was pregnant that day. My husband drove me to the party because I couldn't remember how to get there on my own. I made sales at the party, almost $300. I was super excited about it. Well, after I put orders in, my phone wound up breaking. I tried to contact the rep to tell her I was having second thoughts about continuing Mary Kay because I just found out I was pregnant and my anxiety was through the roof. I had tried to contact her back via my mom's phone, but she refused to talk to me until I had my phone fixed. What? Once my phone was fixed, she said it was great to hear from me again. I told her that I would like to meet with her to return the DVD that she gave me because I didn't feel right selling a product that I personally couldn't use due to breaking me out really bad when I tried it. and my anxiety of having to go to people's houses was getting worse. She tried to talk me into staying on, but I just couldn't do it. I met up with her to return the DVD. She said I could keep the awesome bag that I had received as a part of the kit for signing up. The kit was nothing more than a few cheap mirrors and a few samples of makeup. Before she left, she asked me if there was anything else that was bothering me and why I'm deciding to walk away. I told her it was because of my anxiety and the fact that I hadn't made any sales since my first party. She said it was because I needed to purchase an additional $300 in inventory to prove to people that I was ready to sell. That logic makes no sense. Oh, yeah, just buy more products to prove to people that you can sell. What logic does that? Okay, let's keep going. I told her that I didn't have the $300 and she said, what about your husband? Couldn't he help you? I said I would need to ask him first. She said, why don't you just give me what you can now and ask him for the rest later so I can get you the inventory so you can get back to selling. I knew I couldn't do that because it felt like I was doing something behind my husband's back. She didn't like the answer and again told me that I would be missing out on a golden opportunity to be able to help my husband pay bills and be able to get a new car paid for by Mary Kay. I told her no again and she drove off. Remember when I said I sold $300 at my first and only party? Well, turns out she decided to keep the money. I called to ask her when I would receive the money, and she said that as my upline, and since she came to the party to help me, that the sales would go to her. WTF. I was very upset at that and vowed that day to never again join an MLM. Fast forward 6 years, and my husband's best friend's sister sent me a message on Facebook about an opportunity she had for me with a company called Usborne Books. If you hadn't heard of them, they are a company where you can buy books for kids. Their consultants are called Book Ladies. Well, my husband's best friend's sister was hosting online and asked if I would attend a course online because of the pandemic. I said sure, since my daughter is 4 and loves to read. I didn't buy anything because the books are super expensive and the couple that I was going to get were like $3 each and they were sold out. So the book lady and my husband's friend's sister both asked if I considered becoming a book lady because I would be great at it. I nipped it in the butt right away and said, no, I would only host the party maybe in the future, and now the book lady won't quit bugging me about hosting a party, so I finally stopped replying. Sorry this is super long, just wanted to share my experience. Thanks for taking the time to read and putting out awesome content on your channel. Wow. First off, let me scoot her up, okay? The Mary Kay lady, there has to be a way to get your money back because that's not right. Like, I feel as if you could have reported her. Like, isn't that illegal to just like take somebody's money? I would have went to the cops. I would have called 911. I would have been like, hello, I need to put in a report. Okay, I wouldn't have called 911, but I would have went to the police station and put in a report because that doesn't seem right. And if you've ever worked with Mary Kay or anything like that, is there a way to contact them and talk to them about something like that? Because I feel like that's not right. I feel like you should have gotten that $300. And that's just another way that some of these uplines are just slimy, and all in it for the money. And the second that you leave them, they don't give a crap and they'll just take your money. That's really messed up. But I'm really happy that you kind of stuck to your guns because you stuck to them. You said, no, okay, I'm not coming back. You can go somewhere else. And then she wanted you to kind of like lie to your husband. That's another huge thing that I'm seeing and that I've been seeing for the past couple months is people will tell individuals to lie to their spouses. Like, oh, just lie to your husband. I never really see anyone say lie to your wife or anything like that. Like, I don't see people saying that, but they always say lie to your husband. I'm sorry, but what relationship are you in where it's built on lies and that it's smart to just lie to your spouse? For me, lying is not it. It's just not it. You don't do that, okay? So that was a crazy one. I would love to know what you guys think down below. Also, this past week, I did a video on Mary Kay and their free cars since the MLM rep wanted to say that she could get a free car and it would be a great opportunity. I actually think Mary Kay is one of the hardest ones. Now, back in the day, I do remember my mom using Mary Kay, and I do remember some parties. I would have to ask my mom, but I remember as a kid, there would be like a table set up with a bunch of Mary Kay stuff, and my mom wouldn't do it, but I just know that like her friends would do Mary Kay, and she would buy from them. So I know back in the day, it's something that was very big, but now I feel like there's so many bigger MLMs. Like, there's so many other MLMs that are so much bigger, but apparently to her, it's a big opportunity. And you can get a free car. Cars aren't free. By the way, I have a whole series going on right now where I'm going through all MLMs and talking about their car opportunities. I've done Mary Kay, and I've also done Monet, and then I will be doing, I believe, Arbonne, Lavelle will be the next two that I do. So stay tuned, because they all are kind of similar, but they have different rules. So I really like to break down each MLMs, because Monet's rules are gonna be different than Arbonne rules, so it's kind of not fair to just put them all in one video. So yeah, let me know what you guys thought of today's MLM horror stories. That is going to be it for today's video. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it. Comment what you thought. I love to see your guys' comments. I definitely make sure to respond to as many of them, but I always respond to the first 24 hours. If you comment on my video in the first 24 hours that it is uploaded, I will always respond. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you like content like this, I post Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So I post 3 days a week. Monday and Friday, I do anti-MLM content, and on Wednesdays, I do lifestyle content. So if that's kind of your vibe, if you like lifestyle content or anti-MLM content, this is definitely the channel for you. And I will see you guys in Monday's video.